for the Navy's Blue Angels take to the sky. Now be a great time to grab something quick to eat. Grab a nice cold beverage of choice. Reapply the sunscreen and get ready, Rhode Island, because your United States Navy Blue Angels are up next. We'll be right back after this. So make those final cross checks and let's get ready for departure here with our Blue Angels. If you haven't reapplied your sunscreen, now would be a great time to do it. And then we're getting ready for takeoff with your United States Navy Blue Angels. Stand by, ladies and gentlemen, the Blue Angels are up next. Blue Angel number 7, Captain Jeff Goose.
Performing for you. It's our 20th flight demonstration of the 2015 season. I'm Captain Jeff Coos, narrator for the Blue Angels. The Blue Angel maintenance crew and their equipment travel aboard United States Marine Corps C-130 Hercules, affectionately known as Fat Albert. It is the large blue and white aircraft in position on the runway to your left. Today, Fat Albert will be demonstrating the high-performance climb capability of the Lockheed Martin C-130 Hercules. On the runway from the left, Fat Albert will soon be rolling. They'll accelerate to 125 miles per hour, perform a low transition, and execute a high-performance climb, placing the aircraft in a 45-degree nose-up attitude. Producing more than 18,000 shaft horsepower, enabling takeoffs on runways as short as 2,500 feet. Ladies and gentlemen, Major Cook is now positioning Fat Albert behind the crowd to the right for the parade pass. Flown at 200 feet and airspeeds approaching 300 miles per hour. From the right, the Fat Albert parade pass.
Fire.
course of a complete show season, Fat Albert will fly more than 100,000 miles, carrying a normal show load of 45,000 pounds of fuel, 35,000 pounds of equipment, and a specialized maintenance and support team of 47 personnel. KC-130, they are capable of tactical in-flight refueling of jet, helicopter, and tilt-rotor aircraft. In order to demonstrate the short field landing capability, they will touch down and immediately reposition the propellers to full reverse. You'll notice that not only can the aircraft stop quickly, but it can produce enough thrust to taxi backward. Direct your attention to the ramp before you and observe the military manner in which the six demonstration pilots approach their aircraft and are saluted by their crew chiefs. Ladies and gentlemen, Flight Blue Angel number one, the commanding officer and flight leader of the Blue Angels, from Clifton Township, Michigan, Captain Tom Frosch. Flying Blue Angel number two, the right wingman from Honolulu, Hawaii, Lieutenant Matt Siderhow. Flying Blue Angel number three, the left wingman from Sedan, Kansas, Lieutenant Andy Talbot. Flying Blue Angel number four, the slot pilot from Hubbardstown, Pennsylvania, Lieutenant Commander Nate Barton. Flying Blue Angel number five, the lead solo from Charleroi, Pennsylvania, Lieutenant Commander Mark Tedro. Flying Blue Angel number six, the opposing solo from Bloomington, Illinois, Lieutenant Ryan Chamberlain. The noise level will soon become too high for you to hear a description of the checks that will be performing. However, please note that each aircraft was carefully inspected by expert Blue Angel maintenance personnel prior to this afternoon's aerial demonstration. The Blue Angels fly the Boeing F-818 Hornet, a multi-mission strike fighter, versions of which have been operational throughout the fleet since 1983.
Thank you.
while pilots 5 and 6 fly a solo, demonstrating the maximum performance capability of the aircraft. Once again, I'm Captain Jeff Pugh from Durango, Colorado, Blue Engine number 7, the narrator for the flight demonstration, as well as the pilot for the key influencers and media personnel we normally fly in each show cycle. Blue Engine number 8, Captain Corey Mays from Marston, Massachusetts, is the squadron naval flight officer and event coordinator. Commander Bob Flynn from Morristown, New Jersey, serves as the squadron executive officer. Lieutenant Commander Declan Hartney, our maintenance officer, from Limerick, Ireland, is responsible for the men, women, and equipment that keep our aircraft flying. We're diamond pilots to establish their takeoff formation. In this formation, Blue Angel number 4, the slot pilot, will be positioned in trail of Blue Angels 2 and 3 on Captain Frost's left and right wing. From there, they'll initiate their takeoff roll, transition to the diamond on liftoff, and commence that diamond half squirrel cage on takeoff. Pilots will begin their takeoff maneuvers. In a dynamic display of the thrust produced by these General Electric engines, Lieutenant Commander Tedrow will roll Blue Angel number 5 360 degrees immediately after liftoff with the landing gear still extended. As he spurs the flight line, Lieutenant Chamberlain and Blue Angel number 6 will execute a precise low transition, pull the nose straight up, and complete the maneuver with a graceful split up after takeoff. fired of naval aviators. Approaching center point, Lieutenant Commander Tedrow and Lieutenant Chamberlain will roll their aircraft to 90 degrees angle of bank and push forward on the stick as they perform the opposing knife edge pass. The dirty slow speed handling characteristics of the Boeing FA-18 Hornet. Captain Frosch has called for the extension of the landing gear intelligence by the four Diamond pilots as they execute a maneuver performed by no other jet demonstration team in the world today. From the left, the Diamond Dirty Loop. exit a 7.5G afterburning turn, then exit the flight line vertically, showcasing the Hornet's slow speed climb capability.
Thank you.
and then smoothly shift back into the Blue Angel Diamond. Exit to the left, Captain Frost calls for another formation change prior to detaching Blue Angel number 5. You have seen several flight profiles of the F-18 Hornet. The two solo pilots will now demonstrate precision roll rate control. Approaching center point, they will roll their aircraft 360 degrees, pausing after each 90 degrees of rotation, crossing center point inverted position. The opposing 4-point hesitation roll. Thank you. with a dynamic separation maneuver.
Thank you.
each of the demonstration pilots on the 120 training flights necessary prior to our first public demonstration. At 400 miles per hour, the Delta rolls. All five wingmen maintain position as they roll 360 degrees over center point. Back toward the flight line. Very shortly, all six aircraft will be approaching for the Blue Angel fleur-de-lis. All six aircraft will separate, perform individual 360 degree rolls, and the four Diamond pilots will rendezvous through a looping maneuver. From the left, at 450 miles per hour, the Blue Angel fleur-de-lis. Let's listen in.
Thank you.
Delta is making their approach to the flight line. Approaching center point, the entire formation will separate in dramatic fashion. Ladies and gentlemen, the Blue Angel Delta breakout.
Number 7, Eli Lane from Oakland, California.
Secure their engines, the pilots will simultaneously exit the aircraft on signal from Captain Frosch. It has been an honor and our pleasure to perform for you here in North Kingstown this, our 20th flight demonstration of the 2015 season. Number two, the right wingman from Honolulu, Hawaii, Lieutenant Matt Siderhow. from Clinton Township, Michigan, Captain Tom Frost. Ladies and gentlemen, representing your United States Navy and Marine Corps, the Blue Angels 2015.